Hi, welcome to another Canvas Quick Tip video brought to you by Instructional Technologies. Webex is a powerful tool for scheduling virtual online meetings with your students, other instructors, and guest speakers. It's been integrated within Canvas and is set up so that your students and guests can access sessions that you, as the instructor and host, create throughout the semester. First, we'll have to enable Webex in one of our courses. Navigate to your Canvas dashboard and choose a course where you would like to incorporate Webex. Click on the Settings item in the Course Navigation menu and select the Navigation tab at the top. As discussed in previous videos, here's where you adjust the items that appear within your Courses Navigation menu. The items towards the top are enabled and will be displayed in the menu. Towards the bottom are items that you can enable and include in the menu. Locate and click on the gear drop-down next to the item Meets for Webex and then click on Enable. Meets for Webex should now appear on the top portion of the items. You can click and drag this item to another location on the list if you'd like. Once you're done, click on the blue Save button at the bottom of the page. Let's navigate back to our course's homepage. The Meets for Webex button will now appear on this course's navigation menu and is visible to you and your students. Click on it to access the Webex interface. There are two scheduling options that can be accessed from this screen. The first is a quick, immediate session, and the other is a scheduled session for a later date and time, which can be repeated with a few options. Let's quickly schedule some events for future dates. Click on the gray Schedule More Events button at the top right of the page. A dialog will open up, allowing you to define some options for this series of events. Let's give a simple name to our series. Next, let's choose how often we want this series to repeat. Clicking on Daily or Weekly will give you some extra options, such as the start and end dates of the series, as well as the days of the week that your events will land on. Next, choose your correct time zone, a time, and duration for your events. Finally, click on the drop-down menu under Account. This will determine the type of session that you will be hosting. Each type of session has access to different features within Webex. For general meeting and sharing tools such as an interactive whiteboard, file sharing, and live chat and video conferencing, choose Webex Meeting Center. For a stripped-down interface with less features, select Webex Event Center. For meetings with students or events where we would like a bit more interaction, such as polling, as well as features seen in the Webex Meeting Center sessions, select Webex Training Center. When you're done, click the gray Schedule button. You should now see all of your future events and their details on this page. Next, let's start a quick session. Click on the Quick Launch New Event button towards the top right of the screen. Let's give this event a name and choose its type. For now, let's select Webex Training Center and let's give our session a duration of 1 hour. Once you've chosen a time, click the yellow Launch button in the next pop-up window. If this is the first time that you're running Webex on your computer, you should see a screen that asks to add the Webex extension to Chrome, if you're using Google Chrome, that is. If using Firefox or another browser, a similar window should appear. Add the extension to your browser by clicking the green Add Webex to Your Browser button. When prompted, click the gray Add Extension button. You'll notice that the extension has been added to the top right of Chrome's interface. You should now be ready to continue on to the next video in this series, where we'll learn how to use Webex to host and record live sessions.